Sweet tea, backwoods, trucks, hospitality, and Southern pride. You'll find it all here. This area is the embodiment of Southern culture. You don't normally think of the South when you think of Florida, but the Panhandle is a world away from Miami. Tucked below Alabama and Georgia, it's the narrow strip of land that runs along the Gulf Coast for hundreds of miles. The beaches here are mainly composed of a broken-down quartz crystal, giving the sand a glaringly radiant landscape unique to almost anywhere in the world. There's a little bit of something here for everyone.
I'm a regular guy that lives in a normal house, drives an average car, lives in a working-class neighborhood. I'm out here for extraordinary adventures. I've committed my life to work as hard as I can to travel the world and understand what is out there when many of us do not. I work, I budget, I travel, and I live. And I come home to do it all over again. I've swam off the Alaskan coast, ridden a camel in Morocco, toured Swedish canals, and biked down a volcano in Ecuador. And I'm out here adding more because someone's got to do it. This is One Way Travel.
I've always felt positive around water. It takes the stress away and makes me wonder about the places it connects us to. It's refreshing and always seems to put an important reset button on life. Destin, the heart of the Emerald Coast. What started as a small fishing town, it's transpired into more of a recent tourist mecca in the Panhandle. This is more of a typical expectation of a Floridian town with palm trees everywhere sitting comfortably right on the coast.
Gene Mitchell is a songwriter who spent his earlier years in the Navy. His music focuses on what it's like to live along the coast, but sometimes you can have trouble in paradise. In October of 2018, the Panhandle was hit by Hurricane Michael and the area was destroyed, with the challenge of rebuilding after.
Well, I was in the Navy, you know, 21 years.
Yeah.
Well, I wanted to travel as far as the beaches are concerned. Within the first year I was in the Navy, I was stationed in Hawaii. But when I got in Hawaii in July, by that May, I'd been to Samoa, Tonga, Fiji Islands, New Caledonia, all the way around Australia, New Zealand, Indonesia, the Philippines. I'd already been to all those islands.
Yeah.
And it was just, every time you got on the ship, every time you get on the boat, you go someplace new.
So how's the city doing post-Hurricane Michael?
It's bad. Bad over there. I mean, they're cleaning it up. FEMA just gave a couple $1 million to pick up the debris because that's been on the streets a long time. I know that the landfill had 80 years of landfill space and they've used about 20 years of it. There were probably 800 to 1,000 utility trucks from all over the nation and they were staged over in Frank Brown Park and they had food tents set up for them, porta pots, and they had lights back on so quick. One of the problems with the lights, was removing the trees. The things was, you know, the water got in and just the mold, and it just saturated everything. The insurance company said it's cheaper to rebuild the house than fix it. So a lot of things are leveled to the ground.
Because the storm was almost a Category 5 when it made landfall.
It was like 2 miles or 1 mile less than a Category 5. It was basically a tornado, 30 miles wide, F4 tornado, 30 miles wide, that lasted for about an hour.
Did you stay or did you leave?
I stayed. People that live not near Florida, they're very confused about Florida.
Right.
I mean, the Panhandle is totally different.
What aspects of it feel different here than in Miami?
It's really a part of the South, Georgia and Florida and Alabama. Whereas you go farther south, there's more people from the North that have moved there.
Yeah.
And it's more of a Northern attitudes and more people that want no cold weather. We can get below freezing here. Maybe a night or two, just for a few hours, and it'll get cold.
Is there something about the ocean that you think instills a drive to explore?
I don't know what people think. What I think about when I look out over the water, we live on a continent, and you can be in the middle of the continent, you can go anywhere on the continent. You can walk. You can drive. You can take a horse. But when you look at the water, you can go anywhere in the world in the water.
Yeah.
And that's why. So it's kind of a freedom to look out the horizon. You know it goes over. It keeps on going and wraps around. And to me, when I look at the water, it symbolizes that freedom, and you never know what's over the horizon. On a plane or a car, the joy is not always getting there, but on a boat, the joy is always getting there.
Pensacola Beach is rated as one of the top beaches in Florida, not only because of its sand, but for its restaurants, shops, fishing, and much more. Compared to other places, the beach here tends to be quieter, which makes it a great place to kill some stress. At the west end of the island, you'll find Fort Pickens, which reflects Pensacola's long-standing military history.
Walking around this area makes it really feel like you're exploring some ruins, but it's pretty amazing when you really think about how people actually built something like this over time.
So this is pretty much like the Florida Panhandle's Machu Picchu. It's still pretty intact, but I don't know how these people could fight a war here or do any of that stuff. It's hot as hell in there.
So we're on Santa Rosa Island, which is actually the same island that Pensacola Beach is a part of. So this is all made of sand here, for the most part. And these arches actually go underneath, and it's actually a double arch that they used to construct this fort, which is pretty cool. It actually was meant to stop the sinkage into the sand. So if you actually look behind this fence, you can actually see how it goes into the ground to hold the fort intact.
So the arch actually goes below grade here, so you can actually see where they've actually fenced this off and built it up with sandbags here, but you can see it actually goes below, so that way it has a way of not sinking into the sand, because if these went straight in almost like stakes, after a while this whole fort would collapse.
I'm just north of Panama City at Falling Water State Park. This place popped up on a Facebook ad a while back, and I thought there was no way there was a waterfall in Florida. I fact-checked it, and indeed it was there. The waterfall is about 100 feet high. Its volume changes during the year, but I was able to see a bit of action while I was there. It's $5 for the day pass, and the park is a great place to take a walk and relax out by the lake. It's in a very rural area, so I'm happy to be out in the woods where it's quiet. I'm heading 20 miles west, further into the woods, to Ponce de Leon State Park. The water stays at about 68 degrees year-round, and it's a great place to come on a hot day.
Florida actually has the highest amount of springs for any state in the country. A lot of people don't realize that because there's a lot more than beaches here. Most of the panhandle is actually covered in forests. There's a lot of state parks around the panhandle. They tend to be a lot more of the hole-in-the-wall kinds of places like this, and it's not as beachy in Florida as you'd expect. It's kind of an example of why the panhandle is so different here and how southern the culture is here. This is a clear example of it. We're out in the woods swimming around in the spring right now. My sister runs the cameras, and I decided to lie to her and tell her that it was a hot spring.
You lied to me. This is cold.
Yeah, I did.
You lied to me.
Nah.
You lied to me. Oh my god.
I told her it was a hot spring.
I've never stayed like this with a hot spring.
I can't really tell if she fell for it at all, but she was definitely mad when she resurfaced after she jumped in over there.
For the record, yes, I am pissed.
Pensacola is a typical example of a southern town, but it is changing. Gentrification means something different to everybody, but it's usually based on your income bracket. Either way, this town is changing and more people are coming here for a better life. My friend Richard is among the few people who are Florida natives and who has been here his whole life. We're meeting up for a drink downtown near the bay.
So they drink a lot of beer in this town.
This town is alcoholic as hell. It's definitely like especially on gallery nights, where Friday pretty much shuts down the better part of Halifax. People walk around with beers. It's like it's almost an imitation or a smaller version of Bourbon Street. One aspect of Pensacola that's growing is the arts. And so I think gallery nights started as a means of putting that out there, but any excuse to party and get smashed is a good reason. With the economic growth that's occurred, especially since Ivan in 2004, it's just getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and it allows people to do that kind of thing.
What's causing it to get bigger down there? Could they have gone to any other part of Florida?
I mean, yeah, but I think people are comfortable here. There's a certain climate, even though one thing I don't think people really recognize is that this is kind of the ugly bastard child between the Florida ticky-tacky in the south and BFE Alabama. It's not either one, it's both. And I think that it's comfortable for some persons to retire here. The baby boomers are all retiring, they're moving here. And a lot of young people are finding work, mostly in restaurants. I mean, that's probably one of the biggest business. It's tourism, and that's what sells here.
Yes, there's primarily local places. If you go around up north, it's almost all changed. So is there something about it here that you think makes it unique to the area?
I do think there's a bit of an entrepreneurial spirit here. A lot of businesses come and go. In some places that do find their niche, stay.
Where do you think that entrepreneurial spirit comes from?
I think it's an amalgamation of certain attributes. You have the artsy-fartsy college kids that I mentioned, plus you've got some of the old-school conservatives, but the constant is still the money that's here. From here to Fort Walton to Destin, this is a huge tourist area. And again, based on the beaches, aesthetically the beaches, and the food.
Are you worried about some kind of culture change here, or that things are changing too much here?
No. That depends on if you liked the charm in the first place or not. Before, it was a little town, and that worked. It was a little town next to the coast. There were the beaches. It was next to still the military bases, so those jobs were there. But the dynamic's changing.
So this area has, from what I can tell, especially downtown, they've cleaned up a lot of areas. They've done stuff kind of just outside of downtown. So is that really a good thing or a bad thing?
The problem is that Pensacola, because of its gentrification, because of the upscaling, because of the rising property values, lots of people are losing their homes, lots of people are losing jobs that they had before. The homeless population is growing.
I mean, what are the perks of it? It seems like a lot of people have more of a negative connotation with certain things about it.
If you only have these jobs, that's the only thing you're gonna have. A variety of jobs here is significantly less than you might see in more metropolitan areas, which this place, I think, in the next 50 years could hypothetically be. I don't think it'll ever be New York or New Jersey or Los Angeles or Chicago or Miami, but it is a contender. It has the potential to be that.
A few years back, I came to Pensacola with this guy. Like a lot of people who come here, I was looking for something. I just didn't know what. I guess that's what traveling and exploration is all about, the unknown. What I did know is that I came for a better life, but being near the water has just made me more curious about what's on the other side. The Panhandle leaves the imagination to take hold, and you can find almost anything you want in this amazing place, and that's why I'm proud to call Pensacola my home.